Principle for Rule Bandage Application. Use the suitable bandwidth. Maintain the rule upwards in dominant hand and beginning hand in the other hand, facing the patient. Respect the comfort of the nurse and the patient. Never leave skin surfaces in contact with one another. Protect bony prominences and depressions by means of compresses. Apply the bandage to a clean and dry skin surface. Keep visible the end of the fingers and toes. To start, go from the left to the right. Apply the bandage from the distal towards the proximal area. Make two cycles, one slightly at an angle. Then fold up the formed point and maintain it by the second circular. This avoids slitting. Overlap the preceding turn at 2/3 of the bandwidth. Exert a uniform pressure to avoid slitting and ensure that this is an appropriate tension for the patient. Carry out an aesthetic looking bandage. And by 2 wraps, secure bandages with adhesive plaster or a safety pin. In order to remove the band, pass from one end to the other. Roll up the bandage towards inside to form a ball. Never start and or end the bandage on a wound or a compression zone. The bandage should go 5 cm beyond the edge of the wound on either sides. Place the joints in physiological position for the hands and feet, putting them at right angle. To add the second bandage, overlap with the second bandage after 3 cm, the end of the first bandage. Material: one or several bandages of appropriate size, adhesive tape, safety pin. Implementation: make 2 cycles, the first slightly at an oblique angle, then fold up the formed point and maintain it by the continued wrapping, overlapping turns by 1/3 width of bandage roll. Make 2 cycles, the first slightly at an oblique angle, then fold up the formed point and maintain it by the second cycle. Wrap progressively by crossing the bandage towards the top in a figure 8 fashion. Make sure that crosses are well one above the other. Go up in an oblique manner, then press with the thumb in the middle. Please not on the wound. And fold back the bandage while turning over the bandage roll. The bandage roll is then inside. Carry on in an oblique direction, up and down. Left heel. Start from the top of the head at the right side. make the oblique drops upwards from the heel and downwards on parietal region of the opposite side in order to have a crossing at the location of the brow just above the eye. Stand up beyond the patient. Bandage A describes cycles around the face and nape of the neck. Bandage B describes the repeating ones on the right and left side of the cranium while returning to the middle of the forehead and nape of the neck. A. Make two occipitofrontal cycles. B. Place the lid of the bandage in the middle of the face. A. Secure B by semicycles. B. Direct the lid of the bandage to the nape of the neck. A. Secure B by semicycles. Carried out this technique several times. Secure by two cycles. Secure bandages with adhesive plaster or a safety pin. Stand up behind the patient. Start on the forehead by a first circular. Oblique wraps are made, ascending while passing under the right earlobe. Go up to the interior angle of the right eye at the left top of the head. Stand up behind the patient. Pass under the left heel lobe, then go gradually up, more possibly close to the nose. Cover the first jet of the two-thirds while moving away from the center, which means crossing on the face, then move away from the nose on the high level. Stand up behind the patient. From the nape of the neck, pass through the right top of the head, the interior angle of left eye, and under the left heel lobe. Go down in the nape of the neck, under the right heel lobe, the interior angle of right eye, and pass at the left top of the head. Make a frontal cycle. Three times, repeat the movement while deviating on the one hand from the top of the head, on the other hand from the nose. The wraps cross on the face above the nose.
Do not tighten on the hires. And by two cycles, secure bandages with adhesive plaster or a safety pin. Face the patient. Make two cycles. The first slightly at an oblique angle. Then fold up the foam point and maintain it by the second cycle. Continue a complete cycle at the level of the auricular nail. Form spiral on the back of the hand by leaving the thumb free. Hand by two cycle, then secure bandages with adhesive plaster or a safety pin. Continue to a complete cycle at the level of the auricular nail. Form spicules on the back of the hand by leaving the thumb free. Hand by two cycles. At the wrist, secure bandages with adhesive plaster or a safety pin. If left hand is pronated, start with the thumb. Form the spiral at each finger. Starting with the distal part of each finger. Each time, make the bandage pass over the back of the hand before returning to the wrist. Make one cycle at the wrist before start wrapping the next finger. And by second cycles or two cycles at the wrist, secure bandages with adhesive plaster or a safety pin. Make a complete cycle at the extremity of the thumb. Form spicules by passing each time around the wrist. And by two cycles at the wrist. Secure bandages with adhesive plaster or a safety pin. For arms spiral or triangle, you need to have a sling, a draw sheet in triangle. Ask the patient to bend, his arm to be placed in a sling, bringing the forearm on the chest so that the hand is placed higher than the elbow. Place the bandage under the patient's arm on his chest, the center of a triangle base under the wrist. Angle point at the level of the elbow, neck scarf at the level of the neck. Hold upward, lower the sling of the arm above the wrist. Fix a reef knot on the unaffected side. Never fix it on the spinal column. Explanation. Holding one hand of each rope in each hand, pass the left rope over the right and tuck under. Then pass the same rope, now in the right hand, over the left rope and tuck under. Fold the excess cloth on the level of the elbow. And fix it with safety pins. Fix the arm with a nice bandage. Make a cycle around the thorax at the level of the elbow. While inserting the arm, make the knot on the opposite to the wounded arm. Place yourself behind the patient. Pass the bandage under the armpit. Then turn over the band into backwards while passing over and while drawing strongly on clavicles so as to reduce the fracture. Face the patient. Start upon the articulation. Make a turn in the form of 8 on the top of the articulation and turn over below while going away from the articulation and passing at the same elbow point of the articulation. Continue on the same way so that each turn overlaps the previously by the second third of the bandwidth while going downwards below the articulation and going upwards above the articulation in an aesthetic manner. When the articulation is immobilized, end by 2 cycles at the articulation. Secure bandages with adhesive plaster or a safety pin. Start above the articulation, make 2 cycles, the first slightly at an oblique angle, then fold up the former point and maintain it by the second cycle. Pass obliquely below the articulation, uncircle and go up above the forming spike. Make 4 spikes while covering all the articulation. Thank you. and by 2 cycles above the articulation. Secure bandages with adhesive plaster or a safety pin. First the patient, make 2 cycles, the first slightly at an oblique angle, then fold up the foam point and maintain it by the second cycle. Turn the roll over and bring it back directly above the center of the extremity to cover. Direct the bandage towards the lower section where it is held with the other hand before being brought back at the upper side of the extremity to be recovered. Overlap the previous turn of 2/3 of the bandwidth on the right side of the central bandage. Make then another turn while passing on the left side from central bandage and by still covering it with 2/3. Continue alternating the left and the right side until the extremity is completely covered in an static manner. Fix by a cycle maintaining the base. Continue by spirals or a spica, distal towards proximal. Secure by 2 cycles. Secure bandages with adhesive plaster or a safety pin. Face the patient. Start on the edge of the heel. Make 2 cycles. The first slightly at an oblique angle. Then fold up the foam point and maintain it by the second cycle. Make the first 2 movements of the divergent testudo. Pass on the top of the heel behind ankle. Then in oblique on the side of the heel under the foot plant. Then go upwards while crossing on the articulation. Pass behind ankle on the top of the heel, then in oblique on the other side of the heel. Pass by again under the foot plant, then go upwards while crossing on the articulation. And finally, continue towards the divergent testudo. Hand by 2 cycles. Secure bandages with adhesive plaster or a safety pin.